All right, so ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to the channel and welcome back to yet another video. It's Codebreaker Gaming back with another full gameplay playthrough video series. Today's video playthrough series is going to be from the Dark Pictures Anthology, and this game is entitled Man of Medan, as you can see here on screen. I have no idea what to expect in this game, but I do know that it is one of several games in the Dark Pictures Anthology. I'm not sure if these games are meant to be played in any particular order, but this one was the first one that came up in my category. So we're going to play this game from beginning to end. And if you guys enjoy it, let me see some likes, some comments, and some viewership on this particular video. And as the engagement goes up, the video playthrough series will complete. So without any further delay, let's jump into it. Sit back, relax, grab your snacks, and let's do this. Oh, we got the end user agreement. Skip to end, accept. Skip to end and accept. We're gonna keep that as is. Don't play alone. Play alone. What is this? Whoa, you can play with your friends. How about that? But we're gonna play it alone, because I don't have any friends that play this game, so we're gonna play it alone. And here we go.
Alrighty, Buster. We better mosey on back to the ship.
Whoa. Stop the presses.
What?
Looks like old Charlie Charming's got a little business to attend to.
你能搏斗吗，勇士?
Can I fight?
Hey, give me a quarter.
Why?
Gonna find out my future. Let's have it. What's in store for me, Pop?
你对这些牌有疑问吗?
Oh, am I controlling?
So, when am I gonna hit the jackpot? You know, all that glitz and glamour.
It
looks like a fish.
Your wealth can come from any direction. 但是，当这样的风吹来，死亡和厄运肯定会随之而来。
Traits. Charlie, Okay, so he's either selfish, insecure, altruistic, reckless, eager. So I guess these unlock as I make my decisions. Okay.
Doom? Wait, what? What does that mean? Hey, what does that mean? What the hell, man? Hey, bud, let me get a go at it.
Oh, yeah? Think you got the stuff?
Fight? Sure. Let me another quarter.
Gonna start a tab.
I'll give it a whirl.
Have a nice day.
Hey, Chuck, we better get back to the ship. We don't want to get stranded.
Come on, man. Just let me ask another question.
We really need to get back.
In there. Thank you. Explore the ship. To Pops. Come back soon. What's going on? Yo, this is crazy now. They had me locked in here with a padlock? Are you serious? You can't go this way.
Get me out of here already. What the hell's going on up there? Heard aircraft and gunfire.
Me too. And there was a corpse.
What?
In the sick bay.
Something's wrong. Let's get out of here.
Yeah, we getting out. What's in your room over here. We don't want to go through there. Not yet. No.
Hey, Charlie, help. Foobar and then some.
No, I want to check that door before we go. Oh, I can't go back.
Damn, another stiff?
Oh, damn it, Buckley. Last time I saw him in the mess hall, he was fit as a fiddle.
Poor fucker.
What the hell is going on, bro?
see that kid over there?
No? You feeling all right?
Oh God, no. Charlie!
Won't you spare me over till another year?
Hello. And welcome to my repository. I am the curator of stories. Stories of love and hate, greed and beauty, life and death. Stories such as this one. I'm here to record the story you choose to tell. You see, this tale is only part written, and the choices you make will complete it and determine whether the lives of those with whom you are interfering continue to flourish or whether they are snuffed out. You see, we each make decisions according to our own moral compass, and we have to live with those decisions or die by them. But you shouldn't fear death. It is, after all, inevitable. It is the tax one pays for having lived, and it comes, eventually, to everybody. Still, none of us want for it to come too soon, do we? As in life, the actions you take matter. The choices you make will affect others. I'll be keeping a close eye on your progress. It's not my place to interfere, but I might be persuaded to offer the occasional hint. Here's one for free. There are pictures in this world that can show you some possible futures. If you can find them and study them, they may just help you to make better decisions. Or should I say, decisions that result in the outcomes you would prefer. That's all for the moment. We'll talk again soon enough. We'll have the opportunity to account for all the actions that you've taken, or whatever mess you've made.
Brad, he's witty, Alex's brother, and he's innocent. Alex, who's motivated and insecure, he's Brad's brother and Julia's boyfriend.
Think we got enough?
If we run out, we can always call for backup.
So, look, I've never been down there before.
Down.
The water. Diving. Maybe you could show me how the pros do it.
Are you serious?
Yeah.
I mean, are you serious you came out here without taking any lessons?
Kinda, yeah.
It's what?
It's embarrassing taking them by yourself.
It's embarrassing you came all the way out here expecting me to hold your hand.
Whoa, careful. That dive cam is, like, super expensive.
Look, bro, be cool.
What?
Julia and Conrad are, you know, how do I say it? Super fucking loaded?
So?
So don't sweat the little stuff, man. It's not cool. Don't make me regret letting you tag along.
Tag along? Seriously? I thought I was invited.
Julia wanted you to come along.
For real? Julia?
Yeah, man. She wanted you to come. And I wanted her to see how cool you are, which you're not. So be cool. Capiche? Mm-hmm. All right, amigo. Calvary's almost here.
Cool.
Sorry I'm a little snappy. I'm just... Who knew medical school would be stressful, you know?
Total shocker.
And man, the long distance thing with Julia, it's been rough.
Yeah, I gotcha. Must be tough. No worries, man.
Huh? Yep. Right on cue.
What?
Conrad doesn't think we have enough beer.
Ah. I guess I keep these in an undisclosed location.
Yeah. Hey. So, can I get your input on something?
Yeah, what?
Just, kind of a big thing I'm trying to make a decision about.
About finishing med school?
No, but it's just kind of a big life choice, you know? I don't know what's the right thing to do.
You sure you're ready? Give it some thought. Consider all the permutations.
Hey!
Julia, she's excited and reckless. Conrad's sister, Alex's boyfriend. Conrad, Julia's brother, he's relaxed and foolhardy.
Oh, sorry. Connie, this is Alex.
Hey. What's up, man? It's Conrad. Watch it, sis. Lady killer, right here.
Good to finally meet you, Conrad. This is Brad, by the way. My little bro.
Hey.
Bradley! Feel like I already know you. I've heard so much about you.
Yeah, likewise.
Miss me?
Hey, man. Wanna crack a cold one with me?
Every second.
Cowboy.
I mean, I would have gone with minute. Yeah. Cool. Tight. I love beer.
Right on, Bradical. I like the cut of your ship.
It's jib.
Ruin it. You ever do any diving before?
No, actually. Never done it before.
Water virgin. Nice. Hey, we're gonna pop your cherry together. I'm gonna be gentle. Where's the old crust bucket skipper, anyhow?
Felice, captain of the Duke of Milan. She's impatient and courageous.
I'd invite you to make yourselves at home, but, So is everybody on board and ready to go?
You're selling, I'm buying.
Get it all out.
Yeah.
You want to go lie down?
Yeah. You know, maybe I should.
Yeah. Oh boy.
See those hot pics.
What about over here?
That's pretty far out of the way.
I'm just thinking about backup targets in case we don't find anything on the dive cam.
Listen, to be honest, I've never heard of this wreck you're looking for. Usually these things are crawling with divers.
Yeah. This one's different.
I'm just saying, if it gets too late, I know some nice places where you can just take, you know, a nice dive.
I was so sure it would be here. But yeah, I mean, what are the odds we're really gonna find a needle in a haystack? I'm gonna go help Conrad and Julia with the camera. What you got?
Feast your eyes on this.
Brad's calculations were right on the money.
Always bet on Brad.
Kid's a whiz. We should thank him. Bliss, we found a plane.
Yeah?
Yeah, looks like World War II. We are ready to dive.
Technically, we should call this in to port authorities as an unreported wreck.
Well, technically.
Are you sure you don't want to do this the right way?
Wait, are you saying we shouldn't dive?
The right way. Come on, what is this, kindergarten?
I had to bring it up.
If we just go down and take a look, who's gonna know?
Fine, as long as you're quick. And don't touch anything.
Oh, I just can't wait to be the first one down there. Can you imagine? Untouched?
We should be ready to get you guys in the water in a few.
I'll set up the tanks. The boys will do the final checks. Take a look at the camera, see if you can find anything useful.
Righto.
Hey, maybe you should check on your bro? Almost got the gear good to go.
So, thanks again for springing for the good stuff. Nice to be able to do it right.
Uh-huh.
What?
You know, the size of my bank account is not in a competition with the size of your penis, right?
But if it was a competition, I'd still do pretty good, right?
Well, if you adjust for inflation, gotta say, not too happy with our captain at the moment.
Yeah, I know. Let's just play cool for now.
Cool? Why?
There's no point in antagonizing her.
If she tries to keep me from doing this dive one more time, that's it. Gloves off.
That's fair. Just don't force her hand.
All right. I'm gonna get these rebreathers set up, and then we'll go through the final steps together.
Cool. Just holler at us when you're ready.
October 3rd of 1983. Okay. So she's a Virgo. I'm sorry, a Libra.
This doesn't look kosher. Huh. What am I looking at here?
Premonition unlocked. High and dry. That was scary. Where you at, bro? Oh, he's here. What's this?
What's up? How you doing?
Sorry, that brewski got the better of me.
All part of the adventure.
Sorry for putting a damper on things.
No worries, dude. Took more than that just to screw up the trip. Just get some rest. Come back when you're feeling better. I'm sure Julia left anything on the mainland. This only smelled as good as it cost. At least it made her happy.
You know how to use that?
No. Not really.
Might want to just let it do its thing.
Can't talk to her.
There's a little gap in the tail. Take a look.
Hey guys, tanks are ready.
Thanks a lot.
Okay, so this is the rebreather. Way cooler than a regular scuba setup. It takes all that CO2 that you'd normally just exhale into the water, and instead it gets totally reused. Then it reduces decompression time on your way up. State of the art. Okay, O2 check done. Whoa, 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 Eager Beaver, you gotta check your O2 first.
Thanks for sending me straight.
Okay, you little clownfishes. I'm gonna go see what Fliss is up to.
You behave, Connie.
I know the wait is interminable, but soon it'll just be you and me.
I got the bang stick.
Yeah, I heard that about you.
All right, kids.
Ha ha.
Good to go.
You ever have to use one?
On a shark?
Just remember the rules, please.
You're on camera. I'll take the wheels.
Let's get a before photo.
Fliss is so tight.
She acts like we're going to ransack the plane.
Hey, a souvenir would be cool.
It's not like one tiny little thing would hurt anybody. I won't tell if you won't.
Not like they can scan the wreck every night at sundown. There. That shape. That's gotta be it.
Whoa. That is, like, way bigger than I thought.
Damn. It's pretty intact, too. This is a fucking remarkable find.
Let's swim around a little and find a way in.
Howdy, Captain. You fancy a pint with your second in command?
You are not my second in command.
Third in command.
No.
Fresh and eager cabin boy.
Still a no.
Your well-paying, dashingly handsome, seafaring client is requesting the pleasure of your company over a frosty amber liquid.
pass. I have to stay focused on your friends down there.
Pretty nice ride you got here. Where'd you get the cash?
It's a long story. It's complicated and it's really difficult to explain.
Well, I'm a complicated guy. Try me.
Well, it involves at least several trips to the bank and signing of big stacks of paper with large numbers on them.
So you took out a loan?
You know, you're smarter than you look.
If you're interested, maybe my family can make an investment in your business.
I built this business from scratch. I took out a loan on my boat, and that's all the help I need. Thanks. You know what? I better spend some time keeping the Duke of Milan shipshape.
Aye, aye.
Weather looks clear. Around. How's it going?
Knocked out by cold frosty. Man, I feel like such a wimp.
Yeah, well, go easy on the booze. It doesn't mix well with high seas. That's how accidents happen.
Roger that. Hope the lovebirds are having the time of their lives down there.
I hope they know what they're doing down there. Attitude matters 20 meters down.
Alex plays the goof, but he was pretty serious about acing his diving certification.
What other dives have they done? When I got the booking, I thought they were newbies.
Alex and Julia have both logged plenty of dives. I'm the real amateur. But I'm ready.
Huh. Gotta get back up top. Check you later. Wow, that is not your everyday wreck. I hope those clowns don't get me in trouble. Duke to Alex. Duke to Julia.
That wasn't there before. Somebody's closing in on us. Real close.
What's that about?
That is not the Coast Guard, so we're not under arrest.
How should we handle this?
This feels off. Just be quiet and don't say anything stupid, okay?
Keep back, we've got divers in the water!
Hey, we got damage here, you see this? Look at our boat!
We can take care of this, man, it's not a problem. What do you think, like, $10 cover it? Oh, whoops, my bad, let's make it 20. Well, shoot, you think it's more like 30? I can do 30. All right, you guys drive a hard bargain, but I'm with you. Here, let's just throw in the whole pot.
Conrad said one of the pictures showed an opening.
Conrad, really?
Really? On the rear turret.
Huh. Good on ya, Connie. The turret. We can get in through there.
Dangerous.
Ladies first? Can I just take a second to say, holy shit, Alex, we did it. I mean, can you believe it?
Okay, it keeps looking at the picture, but it definitely looks like there's something right there to pick up. Is that the picture? We'll keep it moving then.
Good God. He's holding something.
Things. They knew they were goners.
You hear that?
Let's check it out. Co-pilot. Gotta be. Plane crash not high on my list of ways to perish. Easy now. This stuff's been down here a long time.
Yeah.
So, we know he's holding something. We don't want to touch that. Is there nothing else in here? I don't think so.
Fuselage. Brad's gonna flip when he sees this.
Julia, leave it. You'd have to take your gear off to get in there. Not worth it. That pipe's pretty tight. What if you get stuck without your rebreather?
Maybe it is kind of dangerous.
It's a gray reef shark. Not interested in us. Let's go. Hold on.
Okay. What are you doing? Why are you fidgeting?
I don't know. I wanted to bring something up with you, but it's not the best time.
Oh, you had something to raise with me, did you?
It doesn't matter. Let's get back up to the top.
Jeez, Alex. You're more of a wreck than that plane that just literally fell apart on top of us.
Give me a break, okay? Come on. We've really got to get up top.
Fliss, this is Julia. We're coming back up. Over. Hey, where'd that other boat come from?
Wait, Julia. We gotta decompress here.
Whoa!
Damn!
What the fuck? We gotta get up there!
Wait! We have to decompress!
Damn it. Yeah, okay. Decompress, right.
Just a few more seconds. Okay, now, go, go!
Hey, what the hell is going on?
What the hell happened?
It's cool, man. Everything's all right now.
Oh, nothing. Your brother just took it upon himself to blow up my grill.
Conrad, what is wrong with you? What was up with that other boat?
These fishing guys came by and ran into the dive line. Whatever. Who cares, right? What I want to know is, what'd you guys find?
Well, we found the plane, and it is huge, full of cool stuff. Unfortunately, we did not leave it as pristine as we could have.
What? Why?
The dive line, actually.
How bad?
There's no cockpit anymore, for starters.
God, well, that's just fucking perfect.
You're getting to know these intrepid adventurers, then. Alex and his little brother, Brad, trying to swim with the big fish. Both seem out of their depth. And Julia, the love of Alex's life, and he the love of hers. What about Conrad, a bold fellow, you might say? Or maybe you'd say arrogant. And then there's Captain Fliss, strong, forthright, stubborn. She appears somewhat immune to Conrad's charms, so far at least. Let me reassure you, you help them to make some decisions they'll value later on. You're doing well.
How well preserved was the plane?
Pretty much what you'd expect.
Brad, it was insane. It was like traveling through time.
No shit.
Well, it was like traveling through time and accidentally ending up in a dimension where the past is underwater and like everything is covered in barnacles and sharks.
Sharks? It was a gray reef.
Ah.
Hey, I thought it was pretty intense.
Wasn't Conrad gonna get us some more beers after he helped Fliss?
Maybe he decided, hey, I'll drink some, and then he got drunk. And since he was drunk, he forgot to bring it to us. And he just kept on drinking, and he drank all of it.
Sounds like you've had some experience with this kind of phenomenon.
Yeah, I've been studying it for years.
I'll go look for him.
Oh, we found a bullet lodged in the plane.
Huh.
I left it below deck if you want to check it out. Hey there, polar bear. You good?
Sorry, I was just thinking about how crazy our dive was. Can you believe what we just got to experience?
Ha! I expected it to be cool, but that was like life-changing cool. What an adventure.
I'm glad at least something on this trip will be memorable.
Every trip we take together is memorable.
You know, you're pretty much the best thing that ever happened to me.
Well, okay. Where's this coming from?
I don't know. Just feeling good. You know where everybody is?
I'll go get him. Why don't you just chill out here? Hey, you seen my brother? Or Fliss?
No, I got distracted.
Let's go get him.
Sure.
So, which one is, you know, where the magic happens?
On behalf of my family, I'd like to apologize for my brother acting like a horny fifth grader.
It's okay. I can deal with children.
Conrad, beers, where are they?
Oh, yeah, the beers. I was just getting them now.
All right, now that everybody's here, let's take a look at the navigator's pad we found. Maybe we can figure out why the plane was out here.
Where'd you put it?
It's in your case.
Okay, I'll go get it.
Hey.
You all right? You seem kind of preoccupied.
No, I'm good. Sorry. Didn't realize I was spacing out.
So, does the accident mean we can't do any more diving?
Let me just say this once more for the record. Going into that plane was super dangerous, obviously, and twice as illegal. Okay? Now damage is done, so we just have to lie about it forever, or else we're gonna go to jail.
Well, my lips are sealed. So, we're going again tomorrow?
Sign me up. Can't wait to see this sucker for myself.
This is so awesome.
Hey, almost time for barbecuing. Got the pad yet?
Oh, no, not yet. I got distracted.
Got it. Let's go out. Come here, you vixen.
Easy, Tiger. We should get back. Right here.
You'll get no resistance there. All right, everyone, check it out. Manchurian gold. Who wants to find some sunken treasure? So what do you think, Captain? Coordinates?
Those are coordinates, all right.
Maybe the plane's destination?
You think we could get there by tomorrow?
It takes a couple hours if the weather stays steady.
Wow. You find anything else?
We did find a bullet stuck in the fuselage, but that was about it.
Reckless, all of you.
Excuse me?
I told you to leave everything down there alone.
Oh, come on. We've been through this already.
I'm not talking about the law.
No, hey. They were respectful.
No, you did whatever you wanted. Whatever you took, it was too much.
Oh, come on. No one knows we've even been down there. And I don't think ghosts can talk.
You Americans are all the same, huh? No respect for anyone else's traditions. You should have never gone down to that plane in the first place. It's bad luck. You think you can scavenge down there and it makes no difference, but every single thing you bring back has an essence. It's like a ghost you invite to the surface.
Here we go.
Huh. I never thought about it like that.
You never think about much of anything.
Well, maybe I never heard about such cool ghost stories.
They're not cool ghost stories. Not like for fun. People drown in these waters and you have to respect their resting place.
Damn straight. Brad, you got a fun ghost story, right?
Yeah, sure, but, you know, nothing like what Fliss is talking about.
Tell us a tale.
Let's hear it. I bet you can spin a good yarn.
It's kind of messed up, actually.
Scare away, little bro.
Okay, here goes. This story is true. It had happened right near here, in an old lighthouse.
Classic setup.
Wait, true story? Where'd you hear this?
Ah, well, down by the dockside, I found an ancient old man, skin like a leather book, eye patch, wooden leg, the whole nine yards. And for a dollar, he told me his secrets.
Seems legit.
The lighthouse stood atop an atoll, isolated from the rest of the world, a lone beacon in the night, a sailor's respite. The lighthouse keeper would hear the waves pounding the rocky shore. One misty morning, he comes upon a woman, covered in blood. She's stumbling down the beach. He hurries to her aid, and she falls into his arms, sobbing. As he hurries her back to the lighthouse, he asks where she's from.
He doesn't waste any time. Smooth.
The woman answers, I live here, in the lighthouse. My parents are upstairs right now.
Twist.
Of course, the lighthouse keeper says, that isn't so. Of course, he's lived there alone for years. And the woman becomes hysterical and insists her parents are upstairs. So, they go to the top of the lighthouse, and there, splayed out on the floor, is a man and a woman brutally murdered with an axe.
Always an axe. I mean, do people even use axes anymore?
I'm just reporting the facts, cliches and all. Chopped up into little tiny giblets with an axe.
So gross.
Okay, so who did it?
The woman says, it was my husband. And she turns to the closet, says, he's in there.
Ah, yes, the husband. And that's why I've always been a little weary of marriage.
So the lighthouse keeper creeps over to the closet, opens the door, and, sure enough, there's a man inside. But he's cut his own throat. Horrified, he looks closer to see the dead man's face in the dark. Closer. Closer. And he sees it's his own face. And then its eyes bulge out and screams.
So gross.
Horrible.
Hey, well, super twist.
Nice.
Nice one, Squire.
You have me going. Pretty cool.
I think you told it better last time. But good effort.
Okay, you've all had your fun. We should all turn in. There's some weather hitting our way.
No, because according to standard vessel regulation, we're all required one more beer before hitting the hay.
What regulations are these?
It's standard issue regulatory institutional protocol subdivision 1099.
Uh-huh. Where'd you read that?
The internet.
Oh, so you found a website that tells you to drink beer under every circumstance.
I'm just following orders, man.
I'm into this website.
And for good, buddy.
And I'm out.
Thank you.
Any worse.
The bad news is these are kind of maybe the fishermen I pissed off earlier.
Oh, God damn it, Conrad.
Great, just great. And the good news?
I recognize them.
How was that good news?
I thought you were gonna ask the good news first.
You're such an idiot, Jesus.
Hey.
Alex, what are they gonna do to us?
I don't even wanna know. I wanna get out of here. I'm in a lot of danger.
Nobody knows you're out here, little lady. You're all alone with us now. Let's make the most of it.
You can go fuck yourself, you piece of shit.
You're the little lady.
Jesus, Conrad.
Stop it! Let her go! You bastards!
careful. Go.
I don't think they're gonna hit her. They haven't hit Fliss.
Fliss sure seems to be getting buddy-buddy with him. Did you see my brother?
Yeah. He's hiding. He's okay.
All right. Turn around. Don't let them see your hands. Once we get Julia back, maybe we could take them by surprise. Okay. They're coming.
Fuck! Motherfuckers!
Hey! Are you okay? What'd they do to you?
I'm fine. They didn't touch me. They asked about our parents.
What?
How much money they have. Wait and see what they want to do with us.
Three, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 seconds. The storm's 8 miles away.
They came here on a boat. Maybe we can take it.
Yeah. Yeah, it's a speedboat.
The main guy, he's got a gun.
Well, at least one of us can get on their boat. Get some help.
These fuckers need to pay. We gotta take them down. They can try to fight back, but if we had the gun, they'd be forced to surrender. 7 seconds. I can get out through the window. We gotta break these off first.
Too loud. They'll hear it.
We're gonna break them during the thunder.
Good call.
I climb out the window, climb around the side, and hit them from there.
We'll take them from the other side. Don't leave us here, okay? Okay, let's do it.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
Hey, what the hell are you thinking?
What the hell, guys?
It's amateur hour over here.
Fliss, I got this. Let me handle it.
Careful! Don't make this worse.
Think about what you're doing, boy.
Conrad, come on! We can beat these assholes!
This kid's trying to kill me also.
Dans la gueule.
Olsen,
here!
Which one of you is gonna tell me about this Manchurian gold?
Give me your best shot.
All right! Shut the fuck up! You know what I like to hear?
Nothing.
That's right.
Nada. Complete fucking silence. Get it?
I'm just gonna say it. Fliss has gotta be in on this. She and these guys, they travel in the same waters. She's the captain, and they barely laid a hand on her? I bet you told them about the Manchurian Gold. They're in cahoots.
I can't believe what I'm hearing. I just lost everything I have, and this is what you think?
You're all in this together. This is a trap, and you set us up!
Yeah, asshole! Put a cork in it. Sit still, all of you.
You, come with me. Find out how long the storm is gonna last. If you try anything, anything fishy, and there'll be consequences. Get it?
Duke of Milan requesting weather update. Over.
We read you. Everything okay? Over.
Hey, just requesting any information about this storm you can give us? It's a little bit hairy out here. Over.
Big storm coming in from the east. Gonna hit you pretty hard, but should pass through your coordinates within an hour. You sound a little stressed, Duke. Please let me know if you need assistance, not used to a little weather freaking you out.
Get him out of there. He's not safe. Brad, buddy, come out!
Move.
Everyone's still alive. Things could have been quite different. Kind-hearted creature I am, I'd like to offer you some forewarning of what's to come. Tempted? Okay, then. We will turn to the Bard for inspiration. The Merchant of Venice, Act 2, Scene 7. The Prince of Morocco pulls a scroll from the eye of a skull and reads, "All that glisters is not gold. Often have you heard that told." Anyway, now that you've reached a point of significant distress, I presume you're eager to get back to your story, but here's a thing. Everything may not be entirely as it seems. Probably shouldn't have said that.
This is a floating death trap. Sign up for a trip to Creep Town.
Something about this place is making my hair stick up so far it's gonna jump out of my neck.
No.
These dickheads owned us.
Oh shit!
Okay, all of you, into the room.
What the hell is this fucking place?
Dude, even those meatheads seem spooked.
You think this ship is the Manchurian Gold?
We are in the vicinity of those coordinates.
We can't just sit around. We need a plan.
Yeah. We're not exactly in the best position to be making any moves.
The second they let their guard down, we gotta take advantage of it and get off the ship.
Yeah, man. This whole rust bucket's one tetanus shot from the bottom of the ocean.
We already tried to escape. Didn't exactly work out.
They swiped our distributor cap. Gonna be difficult to get anywhere without it.
So, okay, what exactly is a distributor cap? Now pretend you're talking to someone who doesn't know anything about boats.
Well, typically, a distributor cap is designed to distribute voltage from the coil to the correct rotor, which in turn... It's an essential part of the engine. We're not taking the Duke of Milan anywhere without it.
While those guys are out panning for Manchurian gold or whatever they think they're gonna find in this floating coffin, we gotta take advantage and look around for a way out of here. Fliss, I just wanted to say that, I might have gotten things kind of wrong back there.
Excuse me?
I may have kind of prematurely come to the conclusion that maybe, you know, you're working some kind of side deal with these guys, or whatever. But I mean, obviously that's not true. They're being just as bad to you as they are to us, so, yeah.
Allow me to translate. He's saying that he's sorry.
Well, I...
Well, your apology is kinda accepted.
Cool. Cool?
Great. Of all the places I'm gonna die on, a bona fide ghost ship.
I'm really scared.
I wonder why
this was ripped off. Any luck?
I can't get it open.
Hey, come here.
If we could bust it open, freedom.
Whoa, we don't know where an event like this would go. Wherever it leads, it can't be worse than here.
You want me to just smash through this wall?
Oh yeah, sure. Big man on campus.
Someone should create a distraction. This is gonna be loud.
Wait. Maybe we should try barricading the door instead.
I'm the reason she got snagged.
Yep, gotta get her.
No way. No heroics. We gotta get as far away from here as we can.
Shit. You're right. I just want to know where the hell they all went.
There should have been dozens of people on board. Hundreds.
How could they all just vanish and leave all of their stuff behind?
Something doesn't add up.
Where's the "you are here" arrow?
terrifying sound, then... This place is fucking massive.
Someone down there, all right.
Wait, look. At the distributor cap. Grab it.
Our son.
Yeah. Go for it. Keep an eye out for me. Yo, Brad. Come on, we gotta think this through, man.
Oh my God, will you wait?
Get out.
Ok. Qui est là? Je vous ai entendu. Qui est là?
Arrête de crier, j'essaie d'entendre ce qui se passe.
Je crie pas.
Ta gueule. Je veux savoir où sont les autres.
Doing? I thought we were following them.
We gotta keep our distance. This way we can get ahead of them.
Let's hope it's faster.
I got this. Makeshift chapel.
Oh, good God. Why do I need to see this now? What was that? You hear that?
Maybe we hit an iceberg.
Not funny.
So?
I swear we've been here before, Alex. Have you been leading us in circles?
Come on, guys, we gotta keep moving.
Soup du jour, mademoiselle?
As if you know your way around a kitchen.
Please, relax. Just messing around. Today's beef casserole. Yummy.
It's as if everything just ground to a halt on this one day. The whole ship just stopped functioning.
Here. What was that?
I didn't hear anything.
Maybe you should get your ears examined, buddy.
Huh? This isn't right.
What? What?
There's something in here with us. Did you hear anything?
All right, well, we should keep moving.
I know I saw something. It was moving in the shadows.
Rats. Probably just rats. That's all it was.
Don't fucking laugh at me! Alright, we've been here before. I'm sure of it. We're going around in circles.
Well, what do you want to do? Turn around?
We've seen all this before.
Cool it, Jay. We don't have a lot of options. It's gotta be this way.
Okay, no. This isn't working for me.
What?
Gross caskets and crappy chapels. Not my scene, you know?
You're right. It's gross and it's crappy. Gotta get out of here too sweet.
And we gotta find Fliss.
Okay, so can we just get the fuck out then? What is this?
Hey, we got a name on this guy.
What are they even doing here? I don't think stuck on a ghost ship for all eternity sounds like a good plan A.
Who cares where they're from or where they're going? They're dead and we're not, so let's keep it that way.
Human?
What is the deal with this place?
That is some bad mojo, dude.
Okay, leave. Now! Leave!
Look at this one. Like for a kid or something.
I don't want to know. Let's get out of here.
Yes! Maybe that's little baby Dracula. Right there, and those are his parents, and they're lying in the dirt from their native country.
And they all jump on Conrad and eat off his face. The end.
Got some serious locks in these caskets.
Why would they be chained and locked?
Well, that's one way to end a relationship.
What's the matter? What is it?
Look!
What?
Seriously? Are you trying to freak me out?
Huh?
Can we just get out of here?
Why so spick and span? Still might have some kick.
4 years of med school and you prescribed me an 80-year-old aspirin and called me in the morning?
That's not gonna make him sick, is it?
Fuck!
Hey, this is no time to be fucking around. I'm serious. I can't take it.
What the fuck?
Don't touch it! Why did you touch it?
Maybe just get in some air.
Conrad!
What the hell? Looks like he died of fright. You can't see that. Okay, so this guy had appendicitis, which is pretty routine, and then he died of a massive heart attack, which is not routine at all.
Hashtag nope, nope. Connie? Connie, where the fuck are you? Where is Conrad?
He must have gone on ahead.
Connie?
Shh, quiet.
I can shout if I want. Connie! Where the hell did he go?
That alone.
You don't even know what you're doing. You just do whatever he tells you, don't you?
Come on. Fucking place is cursed.
What was that noise?
What are you talking about? I don't want to hear anything from you.
Jesus!
Oh Christ. Oh Christ. That guy.
That guy's probably still right here with us. I mean, you die on a ship, your ghost stays on the ship.
Come on. You have no idea what you're talking about. Where did all your friends go?
I don't know what the fuck this is all about, but we gotta keep moving and find Olsen. Now!
Olsen? Merde! Qu'est-ce que tu fais?
What was that?
I'm sorry.
Okay, first of all, how did you get past him? Wait, how did you get here at all?
I was trying to catch up to you, you know, save you or whatever. But then I heard some crazy shit and had to hide in the corner.
I just want to get out of this hellhole and up to fresh air. Can't be a good sign.
What was that?
Beats the hell out of me.
Jesus. What happened down here?
Great. All these hallways look exactly alike.
Hey!
Fliss, hey! Where were you? Absolutely sure.
Shut up
and keep moving.
Thank you.
Who's that? Who's there? Get away!
Skeletons. Skeletons.
Skeletons?
Where's the skin? Some sort of altercation. You're not supposed to be out here. I'm not supposed to see this. Alex? Julia? Oh, fuck no.
This.
Brad. Hey, Brad. What are you... Hey, what's wrong?
What are you doing? Stop it! Brad, stop!
What the fuck?
Thank you.
Drowned. We gotta get away. He's still around. That guy.
Fuck!
You wanted to surprise me with the whole pirate adventure thing, and I gotta say it was a good idea.
No, it was. I mean, it's funny. I think it's funny, but I think the guys you hired are taking it a little too far, maybe. And don't be cheap. I mean, you didn't feel like paying top dollar, and that's... You get these guys that are not cream of the crop. They're taking it a little too far. You know, you get my drift? So if you want to feel free to pull the old plug, get rid of these guys. I'm with you. I mean, these guys are fucking crazy. They're chasing us around the ship.
That's not possible. It's just fucking with me. Hits it. I gotta find everybody.
Whatever this is, it's fucking with me, okay? It's fucking with me. Probably not much of a practice what you preach kind of guy. If anybody knew what the hell was going on in this place, it would have been the captain. Yeah, I should really take a look behind this door, shouldn't I? I should. But should I? Yeah, I should. Well, all right. So how do I pry this son of a bitch open? I gotta find something to pry the door open. Got some heft at least. Enough for the door.
Goddamn, you scared the hell out of me. Come on, we should keep moving. We need to find the others.
How you're feeling right now. I mean, not exactly, but we need to focus on getting out of here first, you know, before we think about anything else, okay?
It's too much. I can't.
Okay, look, me neither. But that's why we need to help each other, okay? We're stronger together, right? At least that way we'll have a chance.
Hello. Things appear to have taken a turn towards the spiritual, wouldn't you say? Now you're one down. And poor Alex. That really wasn't pretty, was it? Have you figured out what's going on? How to stop it? How to save the lives of your poor, unfortunate stowaways. You will, I hope. Although it seems the ship's previous occupants never managed to. Quite a lot of deaths that night. Let me help you out. Give you a little hint. Well then, how can I put this? There may be forces at play here that are more scientific, and even some that are more political, you know? Less supernatural. Perhaps you've started to realize something. That everything and everyone may not be quite what they appear to be. I hope that helps. Well, aren't you excited to find out what your poor unfortunates are making of all this and how you might avoid any more unnecessary tragedy? Go on, back to it. Speak soon.